Hello there. Welcome to this session on services marketing with a practical approach. My name is Dr. Biplab Datta, and my contacts are given here. So once you go through this video and you have certain queries, you can always email me about that, and I'll try to respond to you as early as possible, as much as possible. So this is the seventh lesson, which consists of understanding the macro environment part 3, that is the technological environment, and also understanding the micro environment part 1, that is understanding our company. So we are transitioning from the macro environment to the micro environment in this video. So we see the technological environment. Now this is the fourth and final strand of the environment that has to be analyzed and understood in order to be in tune with the latest developments in the world. So technology has enabled quick transfer of information across the world through the internet. High-tech products have enabled suppliers to satisfy customer needs with lightning-fast speed and accuracy. Now, fast food restaurants are actually high-tech factories churning out high-quality food in the least possible time. So this is where the technology has brought us to. Services are taking increasing help of high technology, be it the time and labor saving accurate automatic teller machines, vacuum cleaners, or the room card with which the guest can access his room, and other services throughout the hotel. So all this, so we see that high technology is affecting the services and the services environment world over. So we must understand how technology is affecting the purchase and consumption of services for consumers. Companies that wish to be on the forefront of efficiency keep watching, documenting, and disseminating advances in technology that they can use to deliver customer satisfaction or customer delight. For example, Ginger Hotels observed that educated, time-starved customers are looking for value for money and like to handle high technology products and services. Accordingly, they started the hotel service where customers can help themselves around the hotel, including checking into their rooms, operating lifts, making tea, etc. So you see that Ginger Hotels took advantage of the technology to help their guests in and around the hotel, with and the guests had to pay substantially lesser than 5-star hotels or even 3-star hotels. So monitoring the macro environment. So we see how the different parts of the macro environment interact with each other. So explosive population growth, which is a social phenomena, leads to more resource depletion, which is an economic phenomena, and pollution, which leads consumers to ask more laws, political, legal, stimulating new technological solutions, which if affordable can alter attitudes and behavior against social. So we see that this political, economic, social, and technological issues, they are intermingled with each other, and if and changes in one of these also affects changes in other types of macro environment. Now we come to the understanding of the micro environment part 1. So there we have understanding our company. Now the in order to launch a service business and conduct it successfully, we have to understand the core competencies and competitive advantage of our business. Our company must have the requisite resources and the capability to process customer possessions in order to produce the intended outputs and experience for the customer. We have to understand the internal strengths and weaknesses of our company. So for example, if we run a cinema theater, we must be able to source motion picture films from the distributors and have a theater and a projector to screen the picture as per the pre-communicated schedule. We must have a facility to sell tickets to our customers. We must have eateries and washrooms for the convenience of our customers. Our service scape must have a pleasant ambience that can delight or at least satisfy our customers while giving them the right experience that they can remember for some time and discuss with others. Now, what are core competencies? We have to understand the core competencies of our company. Core competency is a concept in management theory introduced by C.K. Prahlad and Gary Hamel in 1990. It can be defined as a harmonized combination of multiple resources and skills that distinguish a firm in the marketplace. So, here we have an example of core competencies from the book written by Moore, Sengupta and Slater, that is Marketing of High Technology Products and Services. So, here we see that small engines are the core competency, that is the trunk of the tree, and the trunk of the tree is the core competency, it is the core product or the physical embodiment of core competencies, that is the small engine. Now, the core product must be significantly related to the benefits end user receives. Now, these small engines, this core competency has very strong roots. They have strong roots in superior R&D, superior manufacturing, superior marketing and knowledge of customers, and superior corporate culture. Now, this trunk or the core competency can be useful in various industries like small cars, snow blowers, motorcycles, lawn mowers, etc. Now, branches or canopy represent the widely different product markets to which the core competency has provided access. So, this small engines is the product or the or an embodiment of the core competencies. So, Honda's whole knowledge in the area of small engines helps it to have a core competency and to serve various markets, product markets with that core competency. Then we go to understanding what is competitive advantage. Now, competitive advantage is a business concept describing attributes that allow an organization to outperform its competitors. When a core competency possesses following four characteristics, it is said to possess competitive advantage over its competitors. That is, a core competency must possess these four characteristics, that is, it must be valuable, must be rare, it must be inimitable, and it must be non-substitutable. So, for example, McDonald's has a core competency of churning out burgers and fries in a very small time, in a fraction of an hour. So, here these the equipment and machinery that McDonald's employs, those are valuable, those are rare, they other companies do not have that, and those are inimitable, that means those cannot be copied very easily, and this even the supply services that McDonald's receives from its suppliers, that supply chain is also a core competency of McDonald's, and it is non-substitutable, that is something else cannot take the place of the core competency that McDonald's has. So, McDonald's has a competitive advantage over others. Next, we come to the eighth lesson, which is understanding the microenvironment. Here we see the understanding our customers, understanding our competitors, and understanding our collaborators. Thank you very much for listening. Have a good day.